In this session, we are going to discuss about 11th physics, chapter number 4, laws of motion, part 10. In this part, we are going to solve numericals. Example 1. A car of mass 1.5 ton is running at 72 km per hour on a straight horizontal road. On turning the engine off, it stops in 20 seconds. While running at the same speed on the same road, the driver observes an accident 50 meters in front of him. He immediately applies the brakes and just manages to stop the car at the accident spot. Calculate the braking force. Solution: on turning the engine off, initial velocity u is equal to 20 meter per second, final velocity v is equal to 0 meter per second, and time t is equal to 20 second. Now, formula for acceleration A is equal to V minus U upon T. After substituting the given values, we get A is equal to minus 1 meter per square second. This is frictional retardation, that is negative acceleration. After seeing the accident, U is equal to 20 meter per second, V is equal to 0 meter per second, and distance s is equal to 50 meter. Now acceleration a1 is given by a1 is equal to v square minus u square upon twice s. After substituting the given values, we get a1 is equal to minus 4 meter per square second. This retardation is the combined effect of braking and friction. Thus, braking retardation is equal to 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3 meter per square second. Now, braking force is given by the product of mass and braking retardation. After substituting the given values, braking force is equal to 1500 into 3, which is equal to 4500 Newton. Example 2. Over a given region, a force in Newton varies as F is equal to 3x square minus 2x plus 1. In this region, an object is displaced from x1 is equal to 20 cm to x2 is equal to 40 cm by the given force. Calculate the amount of work done. Solution: formula for work done is W is equal to integration from n1 to n2 f dn, where n is the displacement. After substituting the given values, W is equal to integration from 0.2 to 0.4 in bracket 3x square minus 2x plus 1 into dx. After simplification, we get 0.304 minus 0.168, that is work done W is equal to 0.136 joule. Example 3. Bullets of mass 40 gram each are fired from a machine gun at a rate of 5 per second towards a firmly fixed hard surface of area 10 square centimeter. Each bullet hits normal to the surface at 400 meter per second and rebounds in such a way that
the coefficient of restitution for the collision between bullet and the surface is 0.75. Calculate the average force and average pressure experienced by the surface due to the firing. Solution: for the collision, U1 is equal to 400 meter per second, E is equal to 0.75, and Vn is to be calculated. For the firmly fixed hard surface, U1 is equal to V1, which is equal to 0. Now the formula for coefficient of restitution is E is equal to V1 minus V2 divided by U2 minus U1. After substituting the given values, E is equal to 0.75, which is equal to V1 minus 0 whole divided by 0 minus 400. Therefore, V1 is equal to minus 300 meter per second. This negative sign indicates that the bullet rebounds in exactly opposite direction. Now, change in momentum of each bullet is given by change in momentum of each bullet is equal to m in bracket V1 minus U1. Equal and opposite will be the momentum transferred to the surface per collision. Momentum transferred to the surface per collision is given by P is equal to m in bracket U1 minus U1. After substituting and simplification of the step, we get P is equal to 28 Newton second. The rate of collision is same as rate of firing. Momentum received by the surface per second is given by dP divided by dt, which is equal to 28 into 5, which is equal to 140 Newton. This must be the average force experienced by the surface area. A is equal to 10 square centimeter, which is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 square meter. Now, average pressure experienced is given by pressure P is equal to F upon A. After substituting the given values, we get P is equal to 140 divided by 10 raised to minus 3. After simplification, we get P is equal to 1.4 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per square meter. That is nearly equal to 1.4 times the atmospheric pressure. Thank you.